How to make a blueprint. Go to File and click New. Type in the width of 9020 and the height of 1080. Click OK. Click on the foreground and background colors. Type in the number 065094. Click OK. Now click on the bucket fill tool and click in the image to fill it with the blueprint color. Make a new layer by clicking on the new layer icon left below in the layers panel. Give it a name, for instance grid. Its size automatically is the same as the other layer that's already there. Click OK. Go back to the foreground and background colors and set them back to black and white. Go to Filters, Render, Pattern, and then Checkerboard. I've set the size 160, but depending on the size of the picture you use, you might want to choose another value. Click OK. Now we go back to Filters again and click Edge Detect and then Edge. Here we set the algorithm on gradient. The other values remain as they are by default. Click OK. Go to Mode in the Layer panel and click Screen. Now we can go to File, Open as Layers, and look for the image we want to use. We usually get the best effect when we use a photo from which the background is removed, but it can of course be done with every image we like. If necessary, we can scale our image. Click in the toolbox on the Scale tool. Then we click in the image, which makes the grid visible. In the work window, we must close the chain so the proportions stay intact. Scale the image. When we are satisfied, we can click Scale. Click the Move tool in the toolbox and move the image to its proper position. Now we go to Colors in the menu bar and click Desaturate. This makes our image black and white. Click OK. Go to Filters, Edge Detect and Edge. The algorithm is still on gradient. Click OK. Click Mode and then Screen. Now we are going to add some text to our blueprint. Make sure that our foreground color is white. Go to the Text tool in the toolbox and click it. Make the size 40. Click in the image where you want the text and type your text. Place the mouse cursor on the AA icon, but don't click it. When we turn the mouse wheel, we can see that the font changes, so we can easily choose the one we like. When we've made our choice, we go to the toolbox and select the Rectangle Select tool. Make sure that the blue background layer in the Layer panel is active. Make a rectangle selection around the text. Go to Edit and Stroke Selection. Click Stroke. Then go to Select and click None. I've downloaded from pixabay.com several paper textures and made them into one old and a bit dirty paper texture to give our blueprint a bit of a vintage look. You can of course use any paper textures you like or none and leave the blueprint as it is. But if you do use one, it has to be opened as layers. This new layer comes above our background layer. Click Scale in the toolbox and click in the image to scale it. Make sure it covers the whole underlying image. Click Scale. Go to Mode and change it to Overlay. Now click on the blue background layer to make it active. Go to Colors in the menu bar and click Brightness and Contrast. Here we can make the blue a bit darker if you want. Click OK. And there we have it. The vintage blueprint of an old-timer beetle. I hope you liked the video and that it was helpful. Thanks very much for watching.